Dexter's here.
Welcome to Life Quest. This is yet another week, another Friday, that we are going again to go deeper into the real life quest. I am your friend, a clinical psychologist, who is willing and ready to help you navigate your daily life and the behavior of your body and mind to get them straightened in accordance to your dreams and whatever you want to achieve. And you know what? We're going to do this together, and I'll be bringing in some friends, some guests from different places who will be sharing with us on their success stories such as, say, depression. Someone who was basically maybe struggling with drug addiction and stuff like that. So we'll be getting these stories and many, many, many more. So get tuned, because this is your chance. You know, I just decided that I'll be here to help you to deal with those silent questions, the secret questions that we never want to ask people or we never want to share with people. This doesn't know your setting, your capacity, whether you're rich, you're poor, whether you're a businessman, whether you're a celebrity, whether you're just a common person, or whether you're a student, a married person, or a single person. This is all about you. It is all about life and the body behavior connected to our brains. Now, we all know that brains are the main controller of everything that we say and we do. Yes, there's nothing that you say and do unless your brain has processed and given the elements of senses to your minds. So we got to put your brains right so that you'll achieve and overcome the secret wars that you fight every day and every night. And I'm excited because, you know what, no one had come out to help you understand these things, because all you need is to visit a physiotherapist or a clinician or something like that to help you. But there are just very important things that we can do to avoid these challenges or to overcome these challenges and to win this battle silently. Because typically people get depressed because they deal with the struggle, the wars inside their lives silently. They never want to share with people. Why do people get depressed? So today I'll be sharing with you about depression. This is a very, very ideal key, that a topic that will help you to understand a very important things that are happening in your life. And because the problem now we are facing is about the pandemic in Africa, in America, in Europe, in all the four continents of the world. It is everywhere. In America, suicide is a number two killer disease, and almost over 4 million people are struggling with depression each year. And so this means that the enemy is with us, and we need to know how we can avoid this enemy so that our destinies, our careers, and our jobs, our whatever capacity we are in, we don't lose our goals, we don't lose our dreams, and we don't lose our target. Because if you don't have a sober mind, you'll definitely not be able to process the issues and events in your life. So what is depression? Depression is a mental, it's a mental health disorder characterized by persistently depressed mood or loss of interest in activity, causing significant insignificant activity or significant behavior of your body every day. So I began earlier by telling you that whatever we switch onto our lives, the body and the mind will obey and adapt our new systems. So, what happens? Whatever we say and whatever we do, it's all about the brain. The brain commands what we do, and the brain has the power to choose how to make you. So if you don't know how to feed your brains right, how to handle your brains will override you, and you definitely might lose out. You might fail to get out. Why? Because brains feed from you. Brains feed from everything around you, the environment, the sounds, the things you touch, the feeling, the senses. So the brain is all about the surrounding and the environment. You'll eat the good food, delicious food, and your brain will say, this is good. And your thoughts will be like, yeah, this is it. I got the right thing. And you know what? You'll go on Facebook, find a very, very funny message or comment, and your brain will be like, this person is an enemy. And definitely your mood changes, your life changes, and typically everything around you starts changing because the behavior of your body is changing. Absolutely. So what happens? Let's move on. The brains are the brain is the master controller of everything we say and do. Don't forget that. Now the brain receives information from our senses. The things we feel, the things we touch, the things we see, they convey the information to the senses. And the senses have got what we call the neurons. The neurons transform the information or transmit the information to the central nervous system, which is called the spinal cord. So the spinal cord processes everything that has received from your senses, and it gives it to the blood, and the glands will chemically transform the information into your blood and to the entire body. And this is the funniest thing, that the neurons, a human brain has got over 100 billion neurons. These are agents that transmit information in your body, in your blood. So when you receive bad news, it's not all about the mind, it's also about the blood. That's why you see people collapsing when they receive bad news. What happens? The neurons become fiery when they receive information that is considerably unusual. If or when your brains receive strange information, the neurons, which are elements in your body that function with your in transmitting the information around your body, they become fiery. Hey, so just wait a minute. When people receive bad news and they react, there's a chemical reaction that has happened in their body. So that chemical reaction will definitely influence the behavior of the body. And when the fiery information, the fire, when I mean fiery, I mean fire for fire. You know what? Everything that you receive that you don't like, neurons don't like. So the neurons are billions and billions. that function to take the information to the spinal cord, and definitely spinal cord controls literally every behavior on how you speak, how you think, your intelligence, your judgment, your reasoning, your everything. The neurons do that job. So, if this is all about the neurons, the brains, the mind, then why is it that someone is depressed and someone can stay depressed without knowing? Because we don't give attention to our body behaviors. We do not realize that we are the bosses of our brains. That means the environment you give to your brain will process it. The information you give to your brain will process it. So, if you receive bad news constantly, that means pain is going to be, you're going to receive constant pain. And that means that your neurons are messengers that transmit information into your blood. So the neurons will always stay fiery. And when they stay fiery, they negatively affect the behavior of your body. Now, if the inside of you, the internal of your body is chaotic, if there is noise in the inside system of your body, definitely the outside, the external output is poor. If you are consistently struggling with depression, these elements in your body, the neurons, will stay fiery and they will not function right because they are not getting the right diet because they are struggling with a strange diet. How can you tell that the neurons know that the diet is strange? Because you see, you can judge. And if you can judge, your intelligence can tell you that this is harmful and this is not harmful. So typically, your brain functions because you choose to feed it. So if you don't feed your brain, it doesn't function. That's why when you go to school, a teacher stands before you and gives information, and the brains will get the diet to process the information and send the information into the faculty of your brain. So your mind is the faculty of all different elements. Your mind is the faculty of your intelligence, is the faculty of your judgment, is the faculty of your perception, is the faculty of so many other things. So if your brain sends the information to your mind, then your mind will judge according to the information received by your brain. So your brain is an organ and your mind is a faculty, is a sector that handles and processes whatever you receive, whatever it receives from that brain. Just as you're receiving this information, it's going, being transmitted into your brains, and your brains are setting this to the mind, and now your intelligence, your judgment is telling you how you so badly needed this, or you don't need it. So that is the judgment according to the intelligence, the faculty in your mind. What is depression? It's the consistently fiery information that is sent into your brains. So the more you stay in an environment that negatively influences your brain, definitely your brain will continually receive the fiery information from the neurons. The neurons speak the language that you give them. If the language is for joy, the neurons will rush so quickly and tell the brain, oh, this is Christmas, this is birthday, this is party. If the neurons say it is sad, then it is either loss, it's either failure, it's either fear, and so many other mentioned but a few. So depression basically is a consistent, it's the consistency of painful information being transmitted into your brains. Simple. That means you can change the environment so that your brain will start to adopt something better. That's why people go to a rehab whenever they reach a point of disorder, because there are several levels that I'll be sharing. There's a normal level of just being depressed. And when the pain is consistent, because remember, when the neurons take fiery information into your brains, this message is chemically transmitted. So information that is received from the outside is transformed into a chemical. So the more you keep the bad chemical into your blood vessels, the more your abnormal functioning starts to deteriorate. As simple as that. So receiving and living by wrong information, giving the mind a wrong environment, wrong information, sad information, prolonged sadness, prolonged losses. And you know what? Questions that do not have answers. Whenever you think about those questions, say in marriage, in our career, business, school, any department of your life, any area of your life, whenever you have these unending questions that do not have an answer, you definitely are, you are 100% bound to become a victim of depression. So the more you hold and cling on it, the more you get the chemical, the toxic chemical in your blood constantly moving. Because every time the neurons wants to get back to their, they are called the receptives. Every time they want to get back, they still hold, they cannot relax, because there's polarization and there's depolarization in the brains. There is going up and there is going down. So whenever you hold on to prolonged pain and sadness, it is called polarization. It is going high. And the neurons keep hiking, they keep hiking, they don't go down. So the polarization level continues to become toxic. It continues to affect your body. It continues to affect your thinking. And it continues to deteriorate the normal behaviors of your body. And hence, start affecting your goals, your dreams, your plans. Why? Someone who's depressed becomes vulnerable to so many things. Depression is sickness. And if it doesn't, it is not dealt with, it develops into a disorder. That's when someone becomes mentally unconscious, because the polarization, the neurons are not relaxing. There's no depolarization. The neurons are not going down. You're clinging on the bad side of the story in your life. You're holding on to the failures. You're holding on to the unanswered questions. You don't want to think about letting it go. You're not thinking about choosing to be you and not to look into what people are talking about you. You're not choosing to let you be you. You want to leave some other people. You can't keep on leaving other people. You can't keep on letting people dictate your life. Because basically, when you become a people pleaser, you want to live their life. You are living other people's life and not your life. So the more you want to become a people pleaser, say you're an artist all over the world. Artists want to keep the mark, want to maintain the mark. I'll use them because they are really potential victims of depression. Being that so many people have access into their lives, same people believe that they've got right to their lives. And so as an artist of any capacity, whether a local artist, gospel artist, secular artist, or whatever, any level, you are a potential victim of depression. Talk about marriage, same thing. Talk about business, same thing. We want to do things in our business that will please our clients. Talk about education. We want to perform really good so that the people that are paying for us, or rather the targets that we have in our career, in our education, are well achieved. And so we got to be on this pressure of, what if I don't do it right? Yes. What if you just choose to say that I'm doing it right? It will help you to heal. It will help you to basically avoid the breakdowns in your life. And that way, you will be able to stay cautious. You'll be able to stay sober. Because when the inside of you, you are sober, you definitely are able to influence the outside world. But you cannot influence or impact the outside world if your inside world is chaotic. If your inside world is struggling, you'll be lying to yourself. You need to get back on you and forgive yourself and start looking at the other side of the coin. What if you just don't fear about everything that people say about you? What if you just don't choose to believe the stories that people write about you. You know, what if you just choose to believe that your children are going to be fine, your wife is going to love you anyway, even when your budget has gone low, your finances have gone low. We don't have to leave what we are not. We'll be lying to ourselves. I'll be sharing more on our next session after this break. Welcome your friend. Invite your friend for this Life Quest program.